In this video, we're going to look at how to use the Just Jump system, which can be used to find jump height. The Just Jump system is a contact mat in which microswitches embedded within the contact mat detect flight time. From the flight time, jump height is calculated, and we will look at this a little later in the video. The system is made up of the contact mat and also the handheld computer, which will display both flight time and jump height. In order to set up, you simply place the jump mat on a flat surface and tape down any of the trailing wires, then you're ready to go. To switch on the handheld unit, use a slider at the side to slide it on, and then it'll scroll through some options. Select jump one time using the red button, and then it'll tell you to step on the mat. Once you've stepped on the mat, it'll tell you to just jump, and then provide you with both flight time and jump height. We'll watch that back a couple of times. As with all testing, you should standardise the testing. To standardise, you should instruct the participant or athlete to perform a rapid eccentric phase to a standardised depth, followed by a rapid concentric phase, and ask them to jump as high as possible. You should ensure their hands are kept on their hips throughout the jumps and avoid bending lower limbs during the flight phase. If they fail to achieve these, it is recommended to exclude that trial and repeat. If you need to repeat, the athlete doesn't need to step off the jump mat. They can simply perform their jump again and the unit will provide the updated results. As you could see, the handheld automatically provided two values. On the left is flight time in seconds and on the right is jump height in centimetres. In order to calculate the jump height, microswitches embedded within the contact mat detected the flight time, and the jump height was then calculated using the following equation. Flight time squared multiplied by gravitational acceleration and then divided by 8. You can notice that the result provided seems higher than we just watched. I'm not particularly good at jumping and I don't think I jumped 29 centimetres. It had been noted by a few colleagues that the calculated jump height appeared higher than visually observed. Due to this, Dr. John McMahon from this university led a study to investigate this. In 2016, McMahon et al. Conducted a study in which they aimed to determine the validity and reliability of the Just Jump system for determining jump height. They placed the Just Jump mat directly on top of a force plate and applied the same calculation to determine jump height from both the Just Jump and the force plate. They found that the Just Jump was a reliable field-based measure of determining jump height. However, it was not valid as it overestimated jump height compared to a force plate. Whilst the Just Jump system overestimated, due to the excellent relationship found between the two systems, McMahon et al. Had proposed a correction equation. They suggest that if the correction equation is used, it is viable to use the Just Jump system to monitor changes in jump height in future studies, even though the obtained Just Jump values are inflated in comparison to the criterion method for force plate.